said
hello
to frontman Felix Riebl of the Cat Empire when they jazzed up the charts nearly 20 years ago with a song of the same name. From there, the Aussie six-piece dropped 8 studio albums and dominated the festival scene, becoming a staple on stages here in Oz and around the world. Between the band's success, Felix threw off the cap and popped on his solo pants, releasing his first album over a decade ago and leaning into a more soulful, relaxed sound. Now he's following up with his third solo offering, the deeply personal musical prayer in Everyday Amen.
Say hello to Felix. No, I have, and I'm so sorry. I just butchered it so much. I was so nervous about that.
She practiced so hard.
I practiced really hard, but I'm asking for a friend. Can you go anywhere without having weird people like me just yell those two words at you?
I mean, it's been a while. I feel like that has probably passed a little bit since the days when I walked down the street and people would yell it out at me.
I feel like that's a good thing if I'm going
to... No, it's probably a good thing for me too. Yeah.
What's funny about that song is that's got some cheeky lyrics in there. Like, people kind of forget how, you know, kind of it's raunchy some of those
song,
lyrics
are. A song that I wrote when I was 16 and should stay back then, you know. Yeah.
Talk us through the new album. It's called Everyday Amen, and you've dedicated it to someone very special.
I have. I've dedicated the album to my brother Max, who sadly died of brain cancer about 6 months ago now. He sung on the album with me, and he sung with me on many concerts over the years with the Cat Empire. When he was a boy soprano, he sung a song called Miserere, and then later he was a countertenor, classical singer, and we sung the Royal Albert Hall together in the encore, and then had some wonderful moments like that. And, you know, we'd often play and talk about music, and this album, though it was recorded while he was alive, after he passed, it was for him, and as is much of my music now, I think.
Wow. Yeah.
I mean, this show has a very close relationship with brain cancer, as you
would
know.
It does, yeah. Carrie's done some really inspirational work there. I'm very, very moved by everything that she's done.
Is it the kind of thing where you can only really appreciate all that once you are staring it in the face directly?
I think so. It's one of those things that you're never really prepared for, and it's one of those things that you probably see on the periphery and you hope that it never happens to you. And then when it does, you see that a lot of other people have suffered from, you know, a lot of families have suffered from this as well, and then you find yourself in a place where you're able to be compassionate towards, you know, towards other people's experiences. It's just one of those things. And then you do with it what you will, you know.
Yeah. Well, one of the things you've done with it is this album. I mean, what a cover, by the way. This is extraordinary on so many levels. Talk us through the boxing thing.
Yeah, look, boxing's one of those things that I absolutely love. I'm not particularly good boxer. I've been boxing for a long time, but it's just... it's very rhythmic, and it's just like whenever I need to get in form for a tour, it's not so much that I do practice. It's like you got to get fit and
really?
Back in your body
really?
Again. Yeah, so it's like you got to enter the gym.
You have a particular likeness to Harry Garsard, I've got to say.
Thank you. Yeah, it flatters me. No, but that's, it's just one of those great activities, and it's very, I mean, you're a musician as well, but as a percussionist myself, first and foremost, it's got sort of, it's about flow and it's about sort of getting back on your feet, and it's just a nice feeling. And look, this cover doesn't take itself too seriously because it's scribbled all over by kids, you know. And so it's kind of that was sort of the so much of this album. It's got a serious aspect to it, but it's also got you know, cyclonic young children scribbling on the kitchen table, and anything that you take serious is no longer sacrosanct because it's all of a sudden taken over by them. So this album is very much about the international, the dramatic, the self-serious, and then also the very sort of sublime, domestic, banal, but turned on its head in a magic sort of way.
Yeah, that's beautifully said.
It's so wonderful, and I encourage everyone to go out and buy it. Felix's new album, Everyday Amen, is out tomorrow. Felix Riebl, thank you so much for joining us on the project, and I'm so sorry once again for butchering those words.
Thank you.